This bill, in my opinion, is being pushed by people who wants to negate the democratic space and governance enjoyed by political parties and their rank and file membership, as provided for in Article 260 of the Constitution and Chapter 7 of the Constitution. Why do I say so? This bill is interfering with the Political Parties Act, and for the first time is creating a myriad of definitions. If you look at Clause 2, Clause 5, Clause 8B. So the whole architecture of the political parties definition is being redone. Number two, this bill is, amendment bill, is introducing a very rigid requirement for the conduct of party nominations. And I want members of parliament and aspirants along, across the country to be very wary of. The conduct of party nominations is being skewered, is being managed, and this is a plan to lock out and deny aspirants and candidates by political parties if this amendment B passes, and hence contravenes Article 38 of the Constitution on political, the guarantee on political rights. Thirdly, this bill is introducing a very ambiguous formula for the redistribution of political parties fund. Political parties fund is now well structured that for you to access that fund, you must get certain number of votes and you must qualify to be a parliamentary party. But this formula which has been put here is like you are creating a scenario where you want even to pay certain part of the taxpayers' money to fringe parties, to parties that even will not have qualified to be a parliamentary party. But more fundamentally, and that's why I'm opposing it, this bill is introducing something called the use of ideological argument in the registration of political parties and in the deregistration of political parties. For the first time in the history of Kenya, this amendment is very mischievous. And it says, for the registrar of political party to give you what we call a temporary registration of a political party, or to register a political party, you must comply with certain doctrines and ideology. In the reading of that amendment, ideology is meant and is being used to lock out certain parties that have already established economic and ideological base. Like UDA, we have an ideological conversation with the people of Kenya on the bottom-up economic model, on the ideology of spearheading the hustler narrative. And we have been around in the political circle. So do not bring an amendment that tomorrow you want to use it to deregister UDA because of the ideological context. That the doctrine of the hustler nation, that the doctrine, the economic doctrine of the bottom-up economic model can be used to redirect a political party. And we are telling our competitors, go to the people, ask for votes, do not hide behind the amendment to the Political Parties Act. Finally, this bill is also trying to limit the political parties' democratic space through nomination. And I want to speak to my colleagues in parliament and even those who are aspiring to be leaders. You are being set a trap. You are being set a trap to lock you out in the nomination. political parties, what they are trying to do in this amendment is that you political parties can use their party constitution to expel a member of parliament who has been elected through a popular initiative by the citizens. If you are a member of Garissa Township, my party can sit one morning and just chase me. Unlike now, that for a member of parliament to be chased, the parameters are set in the constitution. Finally, and more importantly, this bill is being rushed. Is that it's setting a limit, I think in section 8, in the formation of coalitions. It says you can only form coalitions 6 months to the general election. That means coalitions must be formed before February. So there's a pressure going on. And just because, and I want to say it clearly, if you think you can blackmail the regional and ethnic political parties that they have financed, if they think they can blackmail Oka to make a decision either to join Azimio, you go talk to Oka, you go talk to the regional and ethnic parties you have formed. You cannot coerce them through legislation, through a political party. Coalitions can be formed even, and the instruments of the coalition can be registered even 1 month to the election. And it has happened. So why are you limiting the time space? And we are going to amend it, that even 1 month to the general election, coalitions can be formed. So I have already told, and this is not about partisan. This bill, I really want, whether you're ODM, whether you are Jubilee, whether you are UD affiliated, whether you are Wiper, this bill is touching on you, how we conduct political parties. And the moment, in my last conclusion, the moment you infringe, the moment you alter the running of political parties in this country and the party nominations, then you are setting a stage to allow people not to have free, fair, credible and peaceful election. And that's why I'm saying, if this bill is passed, I want to assure you, some of us, me included, we will go to court for interpretation. If this bill is passed, this is the beginning of the meddling and denying the people of Kenya their constitutional right to a free, fair and credible elections.